Hello students, today we will be discussing something about the kinetic energy in general motion and specifically a very innovative way to understand this particular topic. So before I start, there's a question in front of you. You guys can pause this video and try to solve this question and see what answer you get for this. Now I hope you have gone through this question and you have attempted this question. Now to solve this question, dear kids, let us start by understanding what the kinetic energy in any general motion of a rigid body actually means and how can we calculate it. So here I have taken a very special case. What is happening is there is an object and this object is spinning about its own axis. It could be a ring, a disc, it could be a sphere as well, or a cylinder whatsoever. And as it is spinning about its axis, its center of mass is moving along a circular path. The velocity of the center of mass is of this object is V. And as the center of mass is moving in this circle, the angular velocity by which the center of mass covers a certain angle on this circle is given by omega, which is V by R. So this is a different symbol. This is a different symbol. Notice, students, such a motion can actually be understood to be composed of two kind of spins. Now, what is a spin? Spin is specifically, in simple terms, rotation about fixed axis only. Fixed axis. And we know in this case, the kinetic energy is given as half I omega square, where I is the moment of inertia about the axis about which the rotation is happening. Now, dear kids, what are these two different spins? Let us understand this. What I'm trying to say is this: such a motion can be understood to be addition of two spins. Now, one spin is about this particular green axis. Now, if I rub this particular omega, let me rub this out. And if I mark a particular point on this particular object, now what I mean is if the object would not have been moving, would not have been spinning about its own axis, and if it would have only been revolving around this green axis, then at any moment, if you'll draw this particular ring, you'll see that this cross will be on top only. So there'll be no orientation change of this cross about this axis. If I would say there, if this is the radius vector, this radius vector would not change in any direction. Now, in such a case, I can consider that this particular body is rotating about this axis. And if I consider this particular moment of inertia of this body to be IC1, then the moment of inertia about this from the parallel axis theorem will be IC1 plus MR square. Now, what is half I omega square? This is the kinetic energy due to this particular motion of this body, which is one of those spins. That is the spin about the green axis. So we can write it down. Spin about green axis. Notice, students, actually, there is also this particular spin that is happening for this body about this particular axis, that is the geometrical axis. So if I rub out these particular quantities of the motions, then we can visualize that this particular motion is something that about this dotted white axis, this body is just spinning and remaining at that particular place only. And for this motion, the kinetic energy can be written as half I omega square. Now I will be about this axis, that is this axis. So I have written that to be equal to IC. So half IC omega square. Now, dear students, essentially, this is what is happening in totality. So the net kinetic energy can be written as summation of this and this, that is the KE1 and KE2. KE1 is due to the spin about geometric axis. Now you can also see that this particular omega from the right hand thumb rule has a direction vertically upwards, while this particular omega from the right hand thumb rule has a direction inwards. And of course, this is 90 degrees to each other. And therefore, these are two motions which are perpendicular to each other, and therefore, they can be considered separately as well. So the kinetic energy of the motion, that is the net kinetic energy, can be written as KE1 plus KE2. Now, dear students, let us take a very special case. Imagine a simple case of a general motion where the particle is not moving in a circular path as I have taken before, but it is moving in a straight line. Now, a very innovative way to approximate a circle into a straight line is by taking the radius of that circle to be approximately or approaching to be infinity. Now, in that case, first kinetic energy will remain as it is because the spinning is happening about this axis. But the second kinetic energy, that is half IC1 plus MR square omega square, will become half MR square omega square because this term will be exceptionally large as compared to this term. So this term can be neglected. Now, the students, what is the value of omega? Let us go back. This particular omega is V by R. This is from the simple concept of the circular motion. When a point moves with a velocity of V in a circular motion, then its angular velocity is given as V by radius of that circle. Now, dear students, as I substitute the value of this omega to be V by R, this R square will get cancelled out and this will be half mv square. And if I add KE1 and KE2, all I get is half IC omega square plus half mv square. And this is the famous formula that we always learn in the course. But it is not always true. And when it is not always true is when this cannot be neglected in terms of this. Now, this might seem to be a little complicated to you, but there is a very famous example for this question, and that is what I have given you in the starting. Now, the students, in this particular question, we can understand the situation that there are two spins that are happening. One is this spin and one is this spin. The direction of this spin is in this direction, and the direction of this spin angular velocity in this direction. So you can see that this and this are perpendicular to each other and can be considered to be separate. So I have redrawn them again. So in this case, I have not drawn this particular spin here. And in this case, I have not drawn this spin here. So for this only spin, the moment of inertia about the z-axis need to be found out. So what is the moment of inertia of a ring about this axis? That is, dear students, mr square by 2 plus ml square. And the angular velocity is given to be, as we can see, this omega. So I substitute these values. This is nothing but half iz omega square. Please consider what omega I am taking. Now, in this second motion, that is this spin is happening about this axis. And for this rotation, we can write down that KE2 will be half MR square omega square. If I take the moment of inertia about this axis as IC, so dear student, this is nothing but half IC omega square or half IY omega square. So if we add these two terms and we use this condition, that is L is equal to R, and both the omegas are same because it is given in the equation, we get the answer 5 by 4 MR square omega square. So this is how we consider and this is how we solve the kinetic energies in the cases where the center of mass is not moving in a straight line, but it is moving in a curved path in itself.